friends and neighbors. This is the Bluegrass Timeline, and I'm Jan Johansson. Since so very few music styles are associated with one name, as bluegrass, I think we're going to start out with that particular person. And, of course, the name we all encounter is Bill Monroe. I'm going to start the year 1936. That's when Bill and Charlie, the Monroe Brothers, came to Charlotte and recorded there for the Bluebird label, which was a subsidiary of RCA Victor. The first song they recorded is this one called What Would You Give in Exchange for Your Soul? And this was in 1936. Around the same time, they played morning shows on WPTF in Raleigh. Here it is. What would you give in exchange for your soul?
Brother afar from a savior today, risking your soul. Would you give
in exchange?
What would you give
in exchange?
What would you give in exchange for your soul? Oh, if today God could call you away, what would you give in exchange for your soul? Mercy is calling you, won't you give me? Must the dear Savior still tenderly plead? Risk not your soul, it is precious indeed. What would you give in exchange for your soul? What would you give
in exchange?
What would you give
in exchange?
What would you give in exchange for your soul? Oh, if today God could call you away, what would you give in exchange for your soul? More than the silver and gold of this earth, more than all jewels the spirit is worth, God the Creator has given it birth. What would you give in exchange for your soul? What would you give
in exchange?
What would you give
in exchange?
What would you give in exchange for your soul? Oh, if today God could call you away, what would you give in exchange for your soul?
So, in 1938, Charlie and Bill Monroe, they broke up, and they broke up here on WPTF, and according to, by now, legend, they came to blows and fought it out there. As a result, Charlie went back to the state of Kentucky, and Bill, he was already thinking about the new sound, so he headed for Greenville, South Carolina, 1939. There, down there, he got together a quartet with the very fine fiddler, Art Wooten, Cleo Davis on guitar, and Amos Guerin on bass, and comedy duties as well. This group, they did an audition, like an audition performance at the Opry in October of 1939. The song they chose to open with was an old Jimmy Rogers piece called Mule Skinner Blues. And later on in 1940, they recorded this Mule Skinner Blues with Bill Monroe and the Bluegrass Boys. Bill was playing guitar for that particular session of Mule Skinner Blues. So here is the 1940 version of Mule Skinner Blues, Bill Monroe and the Bluegrass Boys. Mule Skinner Blues is recorded in 1940 by Bill Monroe and his Bluegrass Boys. So the following year, the United States got involved in World War II. For the coming few years, several of Monroe's band members, who pretty much come and went as they were available, but many of his guys there to the Pacific as well as the European theater of war, and let's say that it didn't have the best effect on the band. So that's that. The World War II ended finally in August of 1945. December 8th of that year. That's a historically very important date because that's the first time Bill Monroe's Bluegrass Boys performed with their new guitar player and their new banjo player. So he's got Lester Flatt, Earl Scruggs, Chubby Wise, and Howard Watts. When we think of bluegrass as we know it today, that's that first group with the same instrumentation, just the same approach to the song, to the songs and to the style that they were starting. So I think we should take a listen from the first recording session with this incarnation of the Bluegrass Boys. It's sometimes also referred to as the original Bluegrass Band. So that would be Bill Monroe, Lester Flatt, Earl Scruggs, Chubby Wise, and Howard Watts. The bass player, he was also known as Cedric Rainwater. And later on, our friend Jody Rainwater joined the band. So bass players normally played the part of the comedian in the band back then. Here it is, Will You Be Loving Another Man? December 8th, 1945.
Now will you love me, little darling? When I'm in some other land, and you know I can't be with you, how will you be loving another man? Will you be loving another man? Will you be loving another man? When I return, will you be waiting? How will you be loving another man? Now don't be crying on my shoulder and telling me the love is grand. And before I'm out of sight, yeah, then be loving another man. Will you be loving another man? Will you be loving another man? When I return, will you be waiting? How will you be loving another man? To be true, dear, I want you to please understand. When I return, don't say you're sorry, just keep on loving another man. Will you be loving another man? Will you be loving another man? When I return, will you be waiting? How will you be loving another man? When I return, will you be waiting? How will you be loving another man?
Well, friends, that was the last song for today. This is a pretty short little program, the Bluegrass Experiment. The last song there was Will You Be Loving Another Man? With Lester Flatt, Earl Scruggs, Chubby Wise, and Howard Watts working for their boss man, Bill Monroe, from 1945, that recording was. The theme song we're using for this show is an original piece I wrote a few years ago, and it's called Tom Hoban. And the musicians on that cut was Lindsey Timms on mandolin, Rick Lester on the bass, and I played the guitar on there.